私を抱いてよね、そばに置いてよ、私の最後の記憶に君の愛を残したい。
Pull out to the float out. You already know though. It's Adamville for real. You see a hoe, just take a photo. I'm reppin' as on photo with a fofo on your bro though. Cause that Jodo thought that he could rob a player for some dodo. Oh no. Also Allen Temple. Also England Manor. Also Misty Valley. And I got a couple pounds yesterday out of Cali. And my bad bitch from the valley bought me brand new balance. And I'm playing with a no American dream. Man, she been ride clean since her daddy rode on pole. I done fucked up in every hoe, telling every hoe. I ain't fucked up with my wife, but if she meet her, might be a go. Big flap, big flap, flashy. Bitch, don't I look dashy. Bitch, don't I look classy. Bitch, don't act so sassy. I'm the man, boo. That's with or without you. The hell with what your mouth say. Show me what that mouth do.
I hear him talking hella reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say lonely at the top, but this the best shit ever. Hey, don't you see me out here shining, bitch? I'm barely flexing. I hear him talking hella reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say lonely at the top, but this the best shit ever. And even if we die today, this shit gon' live forever. Live forever.
Daddy Pets ain't with three X's. Fuck niggas hit the exes. No X's on my chest, but all these diamonds got me blessed. Usually I don't do this. Dumb it down, go stupid. Since 17, been counting M's. My bank account's on goofy. They said Cosby gave them roofies. Now who know what the truth is? Chicago full of shooters. My garage is full of hoopers. Got that southern drawl and all that. My pre-rolls look like ball bags. The side got something to say, and all y'all niggas can't get y'all ball back. If I ain't a hot boy, then what do you call sacks? Daddy Fat in a jaw, never ball back. Like clocks in the wintertime, we stay eating like it's dinner time. Been feasting and cheaping and blowing big, but it ain't no reaper rhyme. We don't know the meaning of drought, cause we keep it so wet, why swear nice, been a while.
Yo, what is going on, guys? It's your boy Purple Slushy. Today I'm bringing you guys a stamina DK build. I haven't brought you guys any stamina builds in a while, so I know you guys are missing out, so I'm definitely gonna hook you guys up with a pretty dope build. So today, the build that I have come up with, it's Maelstrom Axe Sharpened. One Maelstrom Axe Sharpened, one Maelstrom Dagger Precise. This is the best in-slot traits for a dot DK, is one Sharpened Axe and one Precise Dagger, because you're going to want the crit from Precise with the Dagger, and then your Axe, you're going to want it sharpened to increase that physical and spell pen, and you also want the Axe to help you proc bleeds. Now, the reason why I'm using the Maelstrom two-hand, or the Maelstrom dual wields, is because your Flurry will grant you an extra 2,000 weapon and spell damage on the next single target damage over time effect cast within 4 seconds, has a 50% chance to trigger per equipped item. With this enchant, adds 94 weapon damage. This one also adds 94 weapon damage. So basically, before every dot that I do, I'm going to be using Bloodthirst to proc this extra 2,000 weapon damage, so I'm going to be hitting pretty hard. My back bar is a Maelstrom Battle Axe with Sharpened. The reason why I'm using Sharpened is because I do use Werewolf with this build, and while you're in Werewolf, if you have it on your two-hand bar, you can proc your Axe Bleed through your light attacks that you have on your Wolf. Also, you can proc these poisons. The poisons that I use, they deal 1,000 poison damage per second, and then you restore 1,000 health per second for 4.5 seconds. Then it inflicts minor defile to your target and grants you minor vitality, reducing their healing taken by 15% while increasing your healing taken by 8% for 2.4 seconds. The gear that I'm using on my body, I'm using two-piece Bloodspawn. So I'm using 6 heavy and 1 medium. The reason for this, I don't have Undaunted, but you get like an extra 100-something weapon damage just for having one piece of medium armor on. So it's definitely a good choice if you're looking for damage to run one medium with your setup. Two-piece Bloodspawn, the reason why I'm running Bloodspawn is because I use Vitality Pots for this build. Vitality Pots increase your healing received, but at the same time, I'm not going to have the stam from my pots. So I have to rely on my resource management through my ultimate. So using Bloodspawn I'm getting extra 6% chance to generate an extra 15 ultimate and increase your physical and spell resistance by 6,300 for 6 seconds. So this is actually really, really good. It's kind of OP, especially on a DK, because you can almost sustain forever with your ult because you have pretty nice ult gen with Bloodspawn. 5-piece Fury, this is going to give you 1-piece max health, 3 pieces, or 2-piece max health, 3 pieces max stam, 4-piece weapon damage, 5-piece. When you take critical damage, your weapon damage is increased. Not sure the total weapon damage that you're getting from Fury, but you're getting a ton of weapon damage. I've seen my weapon damage go the whole way up to like 4,600. Without even having a resource buff. I'm pretty sure we did have the damage scroll in the campaign though, but I've seen my damage go up really super high with a proc, and then we're rocking 3-piece agility. Everything is robust. The traits on my gear, impen reinforced, I still can't find impen legs. I will switch these reinforced legs out for impen once I get them. Impen gloves, divine's waste, still need a impen fury waste. Then impen infused for my Bloodspawn mask. So I don't have all impen, but it's pretty close to having all impen. Definitely when I get the rest of the impen, it'll make a little bit of a difference. Going over my stats, let me buff up. So buffed up, almost 3,400 weapon damage. Again, we don't have the damage scroll and I don't have a resource buff, so it could get a lot higher. 35,871 max stam, 23k max health, almost 14k max magicka, 1088 stamina recovery with 30% crit, and then my resistances are 25k spell resistance, almost 22k physical resistance. If you look at my back bar, my stamina recovery is even a little bit higher because I'm using Werewolf. I do recommend using the Berserker Werewolf because the bleed damage is very, very good, especially if you apply your dots onto an enemy before you go into Wolf. It's just extra dot damage on top of dot damage, which is really nice. Moves that I'm using for this build: Noxious Breath, it's pretty much my debuff that I use. Blood Craze, it's a heal, also applies a 12,500 physical damage dot. Vigor, Venomous Claw, this is another dot. This is like your most damage dealing dot that you have. It's very, very nice. And then Bloodthirst, so this is also giving me health. And then I apply this before every single dot just to get my damage really high. Front bar, Take Flight, you can rock Dawnbreaker here, but I prefer Take Flight. Back bar, Fossilize, it's my CC. Rally, now you can switch Fossilize out for what's it called? Rearming Trap, it's up to you. I got Rally, Shuffle, Volatile Armor, it's kind of like my buff for physical and spell resistance. Igneous Shield, always need this on a Stam DK, and then Werewolf Berserker. Going over the Werewolf morphs that I have on my moves, Feral Pounce, this is going to increase your time in Werewolf. Hurricane's Rage increases your weapon damage by 10% for 19 seconds. Rousing Roar, now this is definitely the buff that you want. Reason why, grants you major brutality to you and your nearby allies. It's not just your nearby allies, it's you. So it increases your weapon damage by 20% for 22 seconds. Hurricane's Rage, but I usually use them both at the same time just in case, you know, you do. It gives you like 30% extra weapon damage. I doubt it, but you know, it might, because it's not. This just says increases your weapon damage by 10%, and then this increases your weapon damage by 20%, but this gives you major brutality, where this move is not giving you any major or minor, so it might actually stack with it. Howl of Agony, you do 30% more damage to enemies that are feared. Highly recommend using Howl. Claws of Life, you get a decent amount of health. You get... heals you for 66% of the damage done, and then you do a 17k damage over time. So very, very good, very important morph right there. Going into my CP that I'm rocking, we got 91 into Warlord, 48 into Mooncalf, 1 into Arcanist, 1 into Healthy, 33 into Tumbling, 27 into Blessed, 100 into Mighty, 73 into Thaum, 30 into Resistant, 11 into Thick Skin, 72 into Elemental Defender, 48 into Hardy. Also very important, have at least 30 in Resistant, because you unlock this passive. What this does is after roll dodge, you increase your physical and spell resistance for 660 for 3 seconds. So that's extra resistance that you're going to get on top of your blood spawn and on top of your physical and spell resistance buff that you use. You also get this passive right here. When you have 10 points, it gives you 20% chance to restore 15 health when an enemy bashes you. So that's pretty nice. Again, 72 into Elemental Defender, 48 into Hardy, 11 into Thick Skinned. There's a lot more magic sorcs and stuff running around now and magic builds, so that's why I have more stacked into Elemental Defender than Hardy. This is definitely up to you how you want to put your points for your damage reduction. 39 into Quick Recovery. Again, I'm using Vitality Pots, which is increasing your healing received. So I'm just increasing it a little bit more with this passive. You definitely don't have to put any in here. You can put stuff over here. It's up to you. Then real quick, let me show you what these pots do. They did nerf vitality pots. I do know that. I only use the pot like as soon as I'm about to get ulted or as soon as there's a bunch of people on me. That's when I normally pop it. So you restore 1,000 health to you per second for 48.6 seconds, grants you major vitality, increasing your healing taken by 30% for 15.7 seconds. So it's not the full duration that you're going to be getting the increased healing taken, but I mean, it's a decent amount of time. It definitely saves me in a ton of situations. When I'm not using those, I'm just using normal Alliance battle draws. These are normally what I use and when I'm werewolf. I highly recommend making tripods for when you're in werewolf form so you can get your stamina back and your magicka, because you do need magicka for your heal when you're in werewolf. But I hope you guys enjoyed this build. This is my stamina DK build. I'm definitely going to be coming out with more videos. More 1vx videos with this build, a lot more different things with the DK. I might be bringing the Stam Knight Blade out of the bag, but I'm not sure. Hope you guys enjoyed this build. If you have any questions, comments, definitely leave them in the comment section below. Don't forget to like and subscribe and pound that like button. Thank you guys for watching the video. It's been your boy Purple Slushy, and peace. Don't you tell me what's
my heart, sit the tears in my eyes, feel the beat in my chest, it's time to